Was your cancer caused by exposure to a toxic chemical? Can you prove it in a court of law? Those are the questions that I want to talk about for a little bit today. Many clients come into our office and they've been given a devastating diagnosis. They have cancer. And then somewhere along the line, they learn information that makes them think, could it be that my cancer was caused by something in my water supply or in the air or in the soil in my yard? And that's what we help them think through, because those really are questions about, can I prove in a court of law by the rules that apply there that my cancer was caused by something in my environment? So when you go to our firm or another firm that has experienced environmental lawyers working there, here are the kind of questions that they think through. One of the first questions is there still time under the law to file a legal claim for toxic exposure? We're talking here about something called the statute of limitations. That's the period of time that you have, and it tends to be different from one state to the other, very state specific. It's a period of time you have to file your legal claim for toxic exposure in a court of law. Now, when does that time period start to run? That really depends upon the state. But what's important for our purposes today is that you file the claim as quickly as possible, because oftentimes there is a long lag time between, for example, when someone is diagnosed with a cancer, number one, and number two, when they start to appreciate that maybe a toxic exposure may be responsible. That passage of time, which can be many years, may cost that person the right to file their legal claim because the statute of limitations has expired. So one of the most important things an experienced environmental lawyer will tell you is whether there is still time under the facts of your case to file a legal claim. The second question, really, really important, is does the responsible party, let's call that company the polluter, whoever put the toxic chemical into your environment, your water supply, your air, soil, etc., is that polluter still around? If the polluter is still around, do they have the money to compensate you? These cases are very, very time and money intensive. They're loaded with science, complicated to prove. If you prove them, they can be worth a lot of money. Juries can award a lot of money for them. What all of that boils down to is it means that before you undertake a case like that and all of the expense and risk associated with filing it and proving it, that you make sure that the responsible party, the polluter that you're going to sue, has the money to compensate you if you win your case. Now, whether that polluter has the money is something else that an experienced environmental lawyer can figure out for you, oftentimes on the front end, so you don't needlessly undertake the risk and expense and the time and the anguish of going through a lawsuit like that, only to find out that the party you've sued doesn't have the money to compensate you. Another question is there support in the medical evidence, let's say medical studies, for a connection between the cancer that you have and the chemical that this company put into your environment? To prove a case like this, there has to be that medical evidence. It can't be a guess. It can't be supposition. There has to be either a medical study or the testimony of an experienced scientist that says exposure to this certain chemical causes the cancer that the plaintiff has. For example, one of the chemicals that we work with in our office very frequently is a chemical known as trichloroethylene, or TCE. Now, there are medical studies that identify specifically the kinds of cancers that TCE is known to cause. There needs to be that linkage, that provable linkage, to be able to win a case in court. So this is another area where an experienced environmental lawyer will have access to the kinds of medical studies that I've been talking about, and access to the kinds of expert medical scientists who will be able to tell you on the front end whether there's a link, and therefore whether a case is even worth bringing, whether it's winnable. A fourth question is, was there enough exposure? Just to use an extreme example. For most chemicals, if you were exposed just for a couple of days, it's probably not going to cause any serious illness, certainly not long term, especially if the levels, the concentrations were low. Most cases, to have a provable case, to be able to prove in a court of law that a toxic exposure caused your cancer, you're going to have to prove a significant exposure. I'm talking about a number of years. how many years really depends on the illness you have, and it depends on the kinds of chemical. But generally it's a number of years, 5, 8, 10 years, and sometimes more. So an experienced environmental lawyer will tell you that, because some people incorrectly assume that just a little bit of exposure can cause a serious illness long term, like a cancer. Now, in some cases, but there are exceptions, that may be true. In most instances, it's going to take years of exposure to significant concentrations of a dangerous cancer-causing chemical in order to be able to prove that that exposure was what caused your cancer. So those are four important issues. There are more, but those are four of the most important ones that an experienced environmental lawyer can help you work through as you consider, as you think about whether or not a toxic exposure caused your cancer, and really, most importantly for our purposes today, whether that exposure can be proven in a court of law to be the cause of your cancer.